Good morning, students. Am I audible? Okay, so we will do the derivation today, okay? So in this diagram you can see this is our capital H. We have that capital H. This is your total head from the data model. Okay? So you can say this head is nothing but your total energy. We'll be having our kinetic energy head, then our pressure head, that is Y, then we have datum head also. Okay? So in this here, for capital H, you can write this expression. So H is nothing but your, first it will be your datum head, then plus Y, then we have V square by twice Z, and we are multiplying by the energy coefficient as our velocity is not constant. V square divided by twice Z. Alpha V square by twice Z. Okay. What is alpha? We have already discussed. It's our energy coefficient. Then we assume, forget about this, you just write assume alpha is equal to 1. Because if you see in the assumption, we have already written that the energy coefficient we are going to consider as 1. So assume alpha is equal to 1. Then your H, capital H will be your Z plus Y square plus V square by twice. Okay. So after that, we need to differentiate the H with respect to X. Okay. We have to differentiate this H with respect to X. X is nothing but your distance. So this is the expression for H. Now we have to differentiate with respect. So it will be dH by dx. Okay? Then dz by dx plus dy by dx plus dd of x d square by twice c, and you substitute this as the equation number. after that, this dH by dx is nothing but is the slope of the total energy line. Okay? Is the slope of the total energy line and is denoted by Sn. And is given by Sn. So you write where dH by dS, dH by dx is nothing but the slope of total energy line. This is nothing but total energy line, okay, and is given by Sn. Okay, then in next line you write dH by dx is equal to negative, since h decreases when x increases. If you increase the distance, our value of h decreases. As you all know, in upstream we have the total energy is maximum, and because of this friction the bottom of the channel, that total energy at the downstream section will be less. So if our, we all know the open channel flow, it's traveling from a higher elevation to a lower elevation. So if we move forward, again it will be reduced. Okay? That is why dH by dx we are going to consider negative, since h decreases when x increases. When we increase the distance, our energy decreases, because if we increase the length of the channel, that means we are increasing the friction. Okay? If the friction is increased, then our energy is decreases. Okay? So that is why we are going to consider as negative. Okay? Then you come to this term, that is dz by dx. This is nothing but is the blade slope and is represented by sb. dz by dx is nothing but a blade slope and is represented by sb. So again, that dz by dx is also negative, since z decreases as x increases. Definitely, if you see in this diagram, your datum head here z is more than datum head here, and say this because of this z. Okay, as that line, datum line is a straight line, is a reference line. And here that bed of level is in a higher elevation, so this Z is always greater than this. Okay? That is why our dz by dx is negative, okay, since Z decreases as x increases. Okay? Now we are going to substitute this value here in equation number 1. dH by dx, we are going to substitute Sf and we are going to take it as negative, okay. So it will be minus Sf, okay. And dz by dx is also minus Sb. So we substitute here. Here, we substitute minus Sf is equal to minus Sb, and other terms will remain same, okay. dy by dx plus dd of x, d square by 2z. So if you bring this Sb in left hand side, it will be positive, because here it is negative. If you bring here, it will be positive. So SB minus SF is equal to, this will remain same, okay? dy by dx plus dd of x d square by yz. Then again, this dy by dx will remain same. Here we will write d by dy, d square by yz will remain same. See, here we have substitute an extra term called dy, so we have to put dy in the numerator also, so that it will be cancelled. And we will get back to this step again. So d by dy, d square by yz, and dy by dx. Okay? Here also we have dy by dx. Here also we have dy by dx. We bring it out. It will be 1 plus d by dy, d square by yz. First you write down till here. Over till here. So then you move on to the next step. SB minus SF, other term this dy by dx will remain same. 1 plus d by dy. Then we replace that velocity, that discharge is equal to area multiplied by velocity. I can say velocity is equal to q by a. So we are replacing that velocity q by a. So velocity square is there, so q square by a square. Then we move on to the next step. Dy by dx will be there. Sb minus sf. Sb minus sf is equal to dy by dx is there. 1 plus n. Sorry. This is the next step. 1 plus n q square by twice z is your constant term. So we are bringing it out. And what is left out is 1 by a square. So we are going to differentiate 1 by a square. So this will be your minus 2, because if you differentiate this 1 by a square, or you can write a to the power minus 2. If you differentiate this, it will be minus 2 a to the power minus 2 minus 1. Okay? So it will be minus 2 a to the power minus, okay? Or you can write minus 2 divided by a cube. After differentiate, you will get this, okay? But a is not y, because we are differentiating with respect to y. But a is a function of y. So it will be again dA by du. So we will be having 1 by a square. So you can write a to the power minus 2. If you differentiate this, we will get minus 2 a to the power minus 2 minus 1. Okay. It will be minus 2 a to the power minus 3. We can also write minus 2 divided by a cube. Okay. Multiplied by, again, your a is a function of y, but it's not y. Okay. So we have to differentiate again area with respect to y. So dA by dB. So dy by dx will be remain same. 1 plus 2 is there, minus 2 is there, and here also twice z. So this 2 will be cancelled out. We will be having minus is there. Q square divided by z multiplied by, we will be having a cube. So here also we have a cube. And we all know, we have discussed many times, dA by dy is nothing but your topic. Have discussed many times, dA by dy is nothing but your top method. So in place of dA by dy, you can write top method. So then again dy by dx will be there, 1 minus, because here we have minus, so it will be, changes this plus sign will change to minus, q square t by ga cube, okay? Further if you write, because here we have sb minus sf, okay? Here we have sb minus sf. Find an expression for dy by dx, this will come in denominator. Okay? So, sb minus sf divided by 1 minus q square t by ga cube. Minus q square t by ga cube. So, this is the general dynamic equation for gradually varying fluid. after this expression, you can put in equation number 2 and you can write this line. Okay, equation 2 is the general dynamic equation of crazily variable. Equation 2 is the general dynamic equation of crazily varied flow. After that, you can write this. Q square T by GA cube. You can write this term as Q square divided by GA square multiplied by T by A. Q square by A square, you can write V square by G. Here also you can write 1 by A by T. A by T is nothing but your D. If you remember, D is equal to A by T. So V square by GD. V square by, this is G and this is D. Okay, GD is equal to, if you remember, our Fraud number is P by root over GD. Okay. G is equal to A by T. Okay. That's actually we are about to bring effort in this particular equation number 2. Okay. So V square by GD. So we have this expression. Okay. E. So that's why we will write this V by root over GD. If you do square, you will get this equation back. Okay. That is V square by GD. Okay. Root over GD multiplied by root over GD is GD. Okay. So you can write this, and in place of this V by root over GD, you can write this expression Q square T by GA cube. In place of this, you can directly write FR square. Okay. That means, here in equation 2, that Q square T by GA cube, you can replace by this with FR square. Okay. You can replace this term with FR square. Do you have any doubts? So we have completed the derivation today. Then we will discuss in the next class what happens when we consider a channel shape like rectangular, okay? Or if the channel is wide rectangular. So what will happen to this dynamic equation of gradually variable? We are going to discuss in the next class. Okay, we are going to end our class here. Then we move on to our M profile and those profile thing. We'll discuss, but the derivation is over here. Then, if you are asked to write the dynamic equation, you can write that equation number 2 or equation number 3. Okay? Equation number 3, you can say this is with Proud number, and equation number 2, based on this, you can write this. That Q square T by GAQ. Okay. So thank you, students.